Hi everyone, welcome to this exciting session by Simply Learn. Today, we have a really interesting topic for you. In this video, we'll be discussing the chi-square test. We'll start by defining what is research and null hypothesis. Then, we'll move on to learn about observed and expected frequencies. You'll see how you can calculate the expected value using a formula. Then, we'll move on to chi-square statistics. We'll learn its limitations, its formula, and its basic concept. After grasping every theoretical knowledge, we'll discuss an example step by step to see how you can calculate the chi-square statistics and the conclusion you can draw from the calculated value. So, let's get started. Research and null hypothesis. The research hypothesis, which is also denoted by H1, says that the two variables are related in the population. The acceptance of the research hypothesis follows the rejection of the null hypothesis. The null hypothesis, H0, says that there is no association between the two variables and they are statistically independent. The null hypothesis has no bearing on the study's outcome unless it is rejected. Now let's define expected and observed frequencies. Expected frequencies are the value that we would get if the two tables were statistically independent. The expected values are calculated based on our null hypothesis. The observed frequencies are those frequencies that we gather ourselves from our observation. To calculate the expected frequency, we have a direct formula. We multiply the row total by the column total and divide the whole value by the total number of observations. Now, let's move on to chi-square test. The chi-square test is a statistical procedure for determining the difference between observed and expected data. This test can also be used to determine whether categorical variables in our data are correlated. It helps to find out whether a difference between two categorical variables is due to chance or a relationship between them. The chi-square test requires no assumption about the shape of population distribution from which the sample is drawn. However, like all inferential techniques, they assume the random sampling. The chi-square test do have some limitations. Firstly, the chi-square test does not give us much information about the strength of the relationship or its significance in the population. The chi-square test is also sensitive to sample size. The calculated chi-square statistics is directly proportional to the size of the sample, which is independent of the strength of the relation between the variables. So, to calculate the chi-square statistics, we have a direct formula. The chi-square statistics, which is also denoted by x square, is equal to summation of expected frequencies minus observed frequencies whole square divided by expected frequencies. The chi-square test statistics follow these 5 steps. First, we make assumptions about random sampling and state its research and null hypothesis. Then, we select the sampling distribution and specify the test statistics, and after that, we compute the test statistics. The value we get is used to decide and interpret the results. Degree of freedom. The degree of freedom is a statistical calculation which represents the number of variables that can vary in a calculation. The degree of freedom can be calculated to ensure that the chi-square test is statistically valid. These tests are frequently used to compare observed data with the data that would be expected to be obtained if a particular hypothesis were true. The formula to calculate degree of freedom is number of rows minus 1 multiplied by number of columns minus 1. So, after knowing the formula, we have a question for you. How many degree of freedom would a table with 3 rows and 2 columns would have? Post your answers in the comment section. Now that we have learned all the theoretical concepts regarding chi-square test, let's understand this more clearly with the help of an example. Let's say we want to know if the gender has anything to do with the handedness of the people. We have the data of 2,237 people in a simple random sample to find out if they are left-handed, right-handed, or both. The results of the survey are shown in the table below. To see if the gender is related to handedness, we perform the chi-square test. The first step is to define the null hypothesis. The null hypothesis says that the gender and handedness are independent to each other. The next step is to calculate the expected values. The expected value is calculated using the formula that is shown in the slide, which is row total into column total divided by the total number of observations. For example, the expected value of a right-handed man can be calculated by multiplying 1067 into 2004 divided by 2237, which comes out to be 956. In a similar manner, you can calculate the expected value for each of the cell. After calculating the expected value, we calculate the value of x square. X square is calculated by the following formula. observed frequency minus expected frequencies whole square divided by expected frequency. So by putting the values in the formula, we get the x square value to be 12. Now we got our x value, which is also the chi square value, to be 12, and the degree of freedom is equal to 2, which is calculated by r minus 1 into c minus 1, where r and c were rows and columns respectively. The alpha value was assumed to be 0.05. We compare our chi-square value with the critical value of the chi-square distribution with the d degree of freedom. So for degree of freedom 2 and alpha level 0.05, the value was 5.991, which was lower than our chi-square value. This states that handedness and gender are not very likely to be independent. With that, we have come to an end to this video on chi-square test. I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, then please put them in the comment sections. Also, if you liked the video, then please subscribe to the Simply Learn channel and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thank you for watching and keep learning.
Hi there. If you like this video, subscribe to the Simply Learn YouTube channel and click here to watch similar videos. To nerd up and get certified, click here.